I mentioned at the top of the show, Thomas Muller, 20 assists so far this season. Lovely little touches today we saw, Frank. What a transformation he's had since the new manager's come in.
That's incredible, and that's what it is when you have the right mentality and you think about being a real professional, not giving up, always forcing maybe sometimes the coach to have a look at you and know that at some point you will have to respond and you will be at the right time at the right moment. And he did that. Of course, Kovac didn't trust him, and he had a few times on the field with him. But as soon as the new coach came in and put him in, I mean, he was there and he was ready. And as he always been, because I always liked this player, thinking about the team, not only thinking about himself. And I'm not surprised that he gives so much assist to the others because he thinks collectively. He doesn't think about his statistic. He doesn't think about his own football. He thinks about getting trophies, winning with his teammates, and he has the price for that because he's a fantastic player. All through his career, he showed that mentality, and now he's get the award.
It's incredible, isn't it, Don? You take a look back at Kovac, sometimes not even starting him. It seems an impossibility now.
It's just outrageous, isn't it? When you look at the attributes on and off the pitch of Thomas Muller, you think about what he's like, and he's good in the air. He's such a good athlete. It's his character, I think, when you watch him inside the dressing room and watch him on the football pitch, you know that his character is infectious. You see the way he plays the game. He's got a smile on his face. He's always full of energy. And that rubs off on the younger players. Even the older players will be looking at him and checking out his attitude as well. But whenever you play him on the pitch, I can't remember too many times that Thomas Muller's ever let the team down. Now, Guardiola wanted to go a different way in the big games, and he maybe thought that he wasn't the silkiest footballer like someone like Thiago is. But I tell you what, if you play and you build a team around him and you get him close to that number nine position, you play him just off in any of the three roles, could be off the right, through the middle, off the left, and you have him arriving late into the box, as you said, he'll get goals and he'll get his assists.
He's clearly loving it as well. Yeah. You can see that.
Yeah, Dan, and I think the most important part about what I see from Thomas Muller currently is the fact that he has reinvented his game. For the first few years that we saw Thomas Muller at the top tier level, we thought of him as a poacher, as a guy who was going to score scrappy goals inside the 6-yard box, who had an instinct for getting on the end of things, on the end of rebounds, on the end of crosses. And here what we find from him is, okay, I cannot be that guy anymore because Robert Lewandowski is that guy. He is the best out-and-out striker in the world. There's no doubt about that. So I'm not going to take him off the field. And so therefore, how do I then position myself where I can impact the game on a consistent manner and a positive manner for this team? And so what he does is just play off of the shoulder of Lewandowski and kind of underneath spaces and go into wide areas. And in order to be able to do that, not only do you have to have the positive attitude that Don and Frank are talking about and some of the leadership qualities that they refer to, but you also have to have a guy who can figure out, okay, you know what? Let me take a good look in the mirror and say, am I better than Lewandowski at what he does? Probably not. And so now I have to find other ways to be useful. And in order to be useful, then I have to work on my delivery. Then I have to work on my touches. And it's not a coincidence. I can imagine that then Thomas Muller, once he made this decision that, you know what, it's not the number nine position for me, I have to go and play somewhere else, that he's working on his crossing because it doesn't happen overnight. You have to be able to not only see the cross, but execute the cross. And now he does that naturally. There's a player here who has shown maturity and has reinvented his game, and Bayern Munich is reaping the benefits.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.